Good morning, friends. This is the video about Maxwell relations. I have already uploaded it in Hindi, and now for those who are not that familiar with that language, I'm presenting it in English too. So see, we'll derive here four different types of Maxwell relations. First of all, you will have to remember this diagram. Wherever you need the Maxwell relations, first you draw this in rough. This is a square that has entropy, pressure, temperature, volume, enthalpy, Gibbs energy, work function, and internal energy as the signs on it, and two down arrows which are heading towards volume and one towards temperature in this diagram. Now from this diagram we are going to derive all those four different categories of Maxwell relations. There are total 20 Maxwell relations including all those. So let's see the type 1. The type 1 is derived when you have middle term equal to function of corner terms. Like G is the middle term here, it will be equal to function of P and T. So we get this equation, G equals function of P and T. And apply this for all other sides, then you will have H equals function of S and P, U equals function of S and V, A equals function of V and T. Just as simple as that. Now see type 2 for next four Maxwell relations. In case of type 2, the logic or the funda that you are supposed to follow is given in this red colored part. For the second category of Maxwell relations, we will do differential of middle term equal to differential of one corner term into its diagonally opposite term, plus differential of another corner term into its diagonally opposite term. So looking at the same diagram that we have used for the first category of Maxwell relations and applying the new formula, so what we are supposed to do, differential of middle term, take any middle term, suppose h, differential of middle term means dh equals differential of one corner term into its diagonally opposite term. So it will be ds into t, that is tds, and plus differential of second corner term into its opposite diagonally opposite term. So it will be plus dp into v, that is vdp. So the whole equation becomes dh equals tds plus vdp. Similarly, you have to make all these equations. Just one important thing that you have to remember is wherever the arrow head comes, you have to take the negative sign, as in case of du. See, for du, differential of middle term is equal to differential of corner term dv, but the arrowhead faces v, therefore it will be minus dv into diagonally opposite p. So minus pdv, and this will be plus ds into t, that is tds. So du becomes tds minus pdv. Why this minus? Because the arrowhead faces v. So before v, there will be minus. Negative if arrow towards middle term or towards the facing the term that you are taking. Similarly for da, you will have differential of middle term, that is dA, equals differential of corner term, that is dT, but since arrowhead is facing to it or it is coming towards the middle term, we'll take minus dT into S, that is minus SDT, and minus dV into P, that is minus VDT. So both minuses, so dA equals minus SDT minus PdV, and similarly for dG. Now the third type of Maxwell relations, for third type of equations, you will use the second type of equations, these equations, to obtain the third type of Maxwell relations. Here first equation was dH equals TdS plus VdP. Now how will you will derive these equations? The funda used here is, out of the two differential terms, you can see in the right hand side there are two differential terms in each equation, ds and dp, and other parameters in other equations, but there are two differentials. So at a time we will take any one constant so that the whole term becomes zero, and then this will be rearranged to get an equation. Suppose in this equation we take s constant, then ds becomes zero, so tds becomes zero, and dh equals vdp. Transferring dp to the denominator, it will become dh by dp equals v, and all this is taking place at constant s, so bracket s. Similarly, when we take p constant, vdp becomes zero and ds goes below dh, so the equation becomes dh by ds at constant p, because we have taken constant pressure, equals t, because t remains this side. Similarly, for other three equations you will do the same. As you can see here, for du equals tds minus pdv, first we take s constant to get this and then v constant to get this. Similarly, for the last two equations we will apply the same. Taking one equation constant at a time, each equation will get two equations. Remember to keep minus sign wherever it is, like dg equals vdp minus sdt. When p is taken constant, this becomes 0, so dg equals minus sdt. If dt goes below dg, it will become dg by dt equals minus s at constant pressure, that is this. So minus remains as it is. Similarly, when we take t constant, sdt becomes 0, so dg by dp becomes equal to v at constant temperature. Now the last and slightly difficult or confusing category of Maxwell relations, but which is also the most asked one in competitive exams. So type 4, these are those four Maxwell relations. To derive these four equations, we'll use this diagram. The diagram is same as I have taken in the type 1, but I have drawn it four times just for the convenience to derive each equation from one diagram. So for first equation, see this one, I have denoted it 1. The same diagram, I have shown the directions from P to T to V, and then S to V to T. What you have to do here is shown in red ink below. Just taking one side at a time, as I have taken the bottom side in the first diagram. What you have to do, you have to take, suppose it's numbered here 1, 2, 3 and 4. So from this equation is taken like 1 by 2 at constant 3 and 4 by 3 at constant 2. These both become equal. D1 by differential of 1 by differential of 2 at constant 3 equals differential of 4 by differential of 3 at constant 2. So simply apply this to all four diagrams and you will get the four equations. Let's look at it. For this equation, it will be these two directions. So dp by dt at constant v equals ds by dv at constant t. Again, you have to watch for the arrowheads. If the arrowhead comes towards the whatever it is value, then you have to take negative, or simply the flow in which you are going. Like I'm going p, t, v, and the arrow also coming downwards, I'm also going downwards. Then it's okay, it will be positive. If my direction is p, t, v, and the arrow goes towards p, upward, then upward, downward goes opposite, so there will be minus sign. So you can remember it like this also, if whatever is easy for you. Now look at the second diagram here. The directions I have taken this side, right hand side, edge of the square. So first direction is this, second direction is this. So the equation will be ds by dp at constant t and dv. Now here I am going from v to t, but the arrow is coming upward, so it is opposite, then it will be minus dv by dt at constant p equals dv ds by dp at constant t. So this is the equation. You get one negative sign. Now from the third diagram, we'll derive the third equation. Here I'm taking the top side. So for the top side, two directions are from here to here and then from here to here. So the equation becomes dV, as arrowhead is coming, minus dV by dS of constant C equals dt, arrowhead is coming, so minus dt by dP at constant S. Since both sides have minuses, we cancel it and the equation becomes positive. Now from the third, fourth diagram, we derive for left side, it will be dt by dS at constant V equals dt by dV at constant S. Now from 40, arrowhead is coming, so minus dt by dV at constant S, here it is minus. So in each case, you get 3 negative and first positive. I hope this video was helpful for you. For any other topic or difficulty regarding chemistry or biochemistry, you can approach through comments below. Please like, share and subscribe. It will encourage me to do more such videos for you all. Thank you and bye.